Hello students, how are you? I hope you are fine at home. Today I am here with 6th and last part of Plant Kingdom of 11th standard. Here we are going to discuss angiosperm, economic importance of angiosperm, classification of angiosperm, plant life cycles and alternation of generation. So let us start the session with characteristic features of angiosperm. The term angiosperm means enclosed seeds, because ovules or seeds are enclosed within the ovary. Angiosperms are considered as most highly evolved and advanced plant. They are called flowering plant with 250,000 different species. Angiosperms are located in wide range of ecological habitats. And they are most dominant vascular plant. The reproductive structure of angiospermic plant is flower, where pollen grains and ovules are developed. Size of angiosperm ranges from tiny, almost microscopic olfia to tall tree eucalyptus that is 100 meter tall. Angiospermic plant provide food, fodder, fuel, timber and as well as medicines, etc. The male sex organ in a flower is a stamen, which consists of elongated filament with an anther at its tip. And anther are responsible for producing pollen grains by the process of meiosis. The female sex organs are carpel or pistil, and it consists of an ovary containing one to many ovules. Pistil is differentiated into stigma, style and ovary. Female gametophyte, that is embryo sac, is present within the ovule. The female gametophyte, that is embryo sac, is highly reduced and consist of single egg cell, two synergids, three antipodals and two polar nuclei. Each cell of an embryo sac is haploid. The two polar nuclei fuses to form secondary nucleus. This you have already read in class 10th also. Now, the process of pollination results in transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the pistil. In angiosperms, there are different modes of pollination, like pollination by wind, by water, by insects, by birds, by bats, and even human being also helps in pollination. When pollen grains reaches the stigma, then it start germinating and it form pollen tubes. This pollen tube reaches the ovule through the styler region. The pollen tube enters the embryo sac, where two male gametes are discharged. How many male gametes? One pollen grain releases two male gametes. Out of two male gametes, one male gamete fuses with the egg cell to form zygote, and this is called as syngamy. And other male gamete fuses with the diploid secondary nucleus to form triploid primary endosperm nucleus, that is also called as PEN, and this process is called as triple fusion. So here we have seen that due to twice fusion, it is called as double fertilization. Now after fertilization of male and female gamete, it results into diploid zygote that develops into an embryo, and primary endosperm nucleus develops into endosperm, and this endosperm provide nourishment to the developing embryo. After fertilization, synergids and antipodal cells degenerates, and meanwhile ovule develops into seeds and ovary develops into fruits. Here you can observe a dicot plant. How you will identify? By identifying the type of root, that is tap root, and the leaves are also having net-like venation, that is called as reticulate venation. Here it is about monocot plant. Here you can see that in the leaf it is parallel venation and roots are also fibrous. Later on we will see the more differences between dicot and monocot plant. Now let us see about economic importance of angiosperms. Angiosperms are major source of food. They provide cereals, pulses, fruits, vegetables and nuts. They are also used as fodder for animals. Flowering plants are the main source of edible oil for cooking. Common spices are also obtained from various parts of the flowering plant. Tea, coffee, coca are the common beverages obtained from the flowering plants. Our Indian system of medicines, that is Ayurveda, utilizes many flowering plants for the cure of various diseases. Many angiospermic trees, particularly dicotyledons, yield valuable hard wood, and this wood are used as timber. For example, teak wood, sal wood, oak wood, sisam wood and sandal wood, etc. Fibers of different qualities are also obtained from various species of flowering plant. There is a long list of useful articles like paper, rubber, volatile oils, tobacco, etc., which we are obtaining from the flowering plant, that is angiospermic plant. Now it is about classification of angiosperm. Angiosperms are divided into two classes, that is dicotyledons, also called as dicot, and monocotyledons, also called as monocot. This classification is based on the presence of number of cotyledons. In monocot, it is one cotyledon, and in dicot, it is two cotyledon. Here you can observe the monocot and dicot plant. In this figure, you may observe the other differences between monocot and dicot. In monocot, veins are usually parallel. Vascular bundles are usually completely arranged. Fibrous root system, floral parts usually in multiple of three, whereas in case of dicots, there are two cotyledons, veins are net-like, that is also called as reticulate. Vascular bundles usually arranged in ring, taproot system is present, and floral parts are usually multiple of four or multiple of five. Now let us see about plant life cycles and alternation of generation. In case of plants, both haploid as well as diploid cells divide by mitotic division to form haploid and diploid plants. Later on, haploid plant body forms gamete by mitosis. Why it is by mitosis? Because gametes are always haploid and the plant is haploid. So there is no need of meiosis. Here the haploid plant forms gamete by mitosis only, and it represents the gametophyte. Fusion of gametes result in zygote after fertilization, and it divides by mitosis to form diploid plant called as sporophyte. Now this sporophyte further form haploid spores by meiosis. Further, haploid spores divide by mitosis to form a haploid plant body, that is gametophyte. Thus, we have seen that in any sexually reproducing plant, there is alternation of generation in the life cycle between gamete producing haploid gametophyte and a spore producing diploid sporophyte. Here it is the figure where you can observe the life cycle of an angiosperm. This red arrow indicates haploid stages and blue arrow indicates the diploid stages in the life cycle. Alternation of generation in the life cycle of a plant is of three types. They are haploentic life cycle, diploentic life cycle and haplodiploentic life cycle. So here we will discuss one by one. First is about haploentic life cycle. In this case, the main vegetative plant body is haploid and a sporophytic generation is represented only by a single cell zygote. The haploid plant body produces male and female gametes by mitosis division. There is no meiosis at the time of gamete formation. The male and female gamete fuses to form zygote, and meiosis in zygote forms haploid spores that divide mitotically to form gametophyte. Haploid plant. So the dominant photosynthetic phase in such plant is gametophyte, and such life cycle is called as haploidic life cycle, which is commonly seen in algae, particularly in Spirogyra, Volvox, Chlamydomonas, etc. Here you may observe the flow chart of haploidic life cycle where gametophytic phase is dominant. Second one is diploidic life cycle. In this case, diploid sporophyte is dominant, photosynthetic and independent phase of the plant. Meiosis occur at the time of sexual reproduction during the formation of gametes. The gametes are haploid, which fuses to form diploid zygote, and this diploid zygote germinates to produce diploid plant body. It is seen in all seed bearing plants, that is in gymnosperm and angiosperm. Here it is the flow chart of diploidic life cycle, which is showing the dominant diploid sporophytic phase in the life cycle. Now last is the haplodiploidic life cycle. In this case, there are two distinct generations of almost equal duration. A dominant independent photosynthetic thyloid or erect phase is represented by a haploid gametophyte, and it alternates with the short-lived multicellular sporophyte, totally or partially dependent on the gametophyte for its anchorage and for nutrition. For example, it is seen in case of bryophyta. In case of pteridophyta, the diploid sporophyte is represented by a dominant independent photosynthetic vascular plant. It alternates with multicellular, saprophytic or autotrophic, independent but short-lived haploid gametophyte. There are some exceptions in case of algae. Ectocarpus, Polysiphonia and kelps are also haplodiploidy, and fucus is a diploidy. So these algae show the different life cycle. Alternation of generation here in case of Ectocarpus, Polysiphonia, kelp are haplodiploidic, whereas in case of fucus it is diploidy. The given flow diagram indicates about the haplodiploidic life cycle, where you may observe almost equal duration of haploid and diploid phases in the life cycle. So this is all about today's session. Thank you. For any kind of doubts, please write your questions in comment section.